just because they've been trying to move Jimmy Butler. They've offered him to a variety of places, and no one was willing to give them a package anywhere close to what the Minnesota Timberwolves gave them. This hinges mostly on Chris Dunn, who I think is ultimately going to be the best player in last year's draft. The fact that Tom Thibodeau decided not to play him, I'm not holding against Chris Dunn. You get a free look at Zach LaVine. I don't know if he's anything more than a great athletic wing. And then you add Markkanen. But this is really about Jimmy Butler, who 2 years ago wanted to be the leader of this team, tried to be this leader of the team. The people around the team were calling him hostile takeover because they were like, we're not following this guy. You saw the same disruption this year. And it's not, again, it's addition by subtraction, and the big look would be a poison pill.
Patted itself as much as any.
That was subject for another video.
We've covered it.
Your best move of the offseason so far. Best move of the offseason so far was by the Brooklyn Nets, of all teams. The team that I know has humiliated itself as much as any over the last few years because of all the picks that they gave away. They got D'Angelo Russell, the number two pick of the draft just 2 years ago, basically for free by taking on Timofey Mozgov's contract that the Lakers were desperate to unload. 3 years and $48 million left because they need cap room. The price of taking on Mozgov, or for them offloading Mozgov, was to give up on D'Angelo Russell. Still just 21 years old, certainly proven as a scorer in this league with plenty of growth ahead of him. Yes, he has his warts, but the Brooklyn Nets, who have to take chances at this point just to get high-level talent in, this was a great move. They don't have control over their picks still. They're not a free agent destination at the moment.